I was doing a little research before I came to Russia because I wanted to like learn a little bit about it. I was watching this documentary that you guys have about global warming. It's called Chernobyl. I don't know if you've seen it. Have you guys seen that? It's pretty hot, man. It gets pretty hot over there. And it was interesting because I was very inspired by the Soviet idea of togetherness, right? These Soviet ideas that were one nation, one flag, one people, no classes, everybody the same. And then Chernobyl happened and you were like, that's Ukraine. I don't know, that's not this. That's them. That's completely different people. It's different. Listen, their prostitutes go to Europe, ours stay here. It's different. It's not the same at all. We don't, Ukraine has nothing to do with Russia, okay? Except Crimea, we take Crimea. But they, Ukraine over there, you don't know.
I currently live in New York City, which is, it's there. I've been living in New York about 6 years now, and when I first moved there, I had a huge fear I was gonna get mugged. Constantly. Like every time I left the house, I was like, here it comes. Someone's gonna take everything. I got over my fear because I learned a trick, and now I use this trick all the time. Whenever I think someone might try to beat me up or mug me, I fake a Russian accent. You're welcome. It's genius. I'll be walking home late at night, two dangerous looking thugs walk up to me like, yo man, you know what neighborhood you're in? You think this bad neighborhood? Russians are the scariest white people. They've earned it. I'm so scared of them that I guarantee you if I was lost, dangerously lost, there is no way I'd ask a Russian for directions. Just real quick, like, sir, help me, please help me. How do I get to the subway? The subway. Walk down street and turn corner. Yeah, screw that. I think I'm just gonna stay lost.
Now, you grew up in Poland. When did you move to Canada?
In
82. 82. So when you grew up in Poland, were you learning, were they speaking Russian back then?
I had to take Russian.
You had to take Russian, right? Yeah, I knew that, right? So you speak Russian or understand it to a certain degree?
Yeah. Certainly.
Yeah. I just learned how to say, how are you in Russian, that's why. You want to say, how are you in Russian, Vince? Cock dealer. I swear, this Russian guy walks up and goes, hey, cock dealer. I go, hey, man. I don't give a shit if you're a blackjack dealer, all right? Don't come around here offering me all that. When you find vag dealer, send her over. I like listening to people speak Russian. You ever heard people speak Russian? It's amazing. They just sound like they're talking backwards the whole time. Vladimir,
a lot of people don't realize there's a lot of similarities between America and Russia. You know, we're not that different, right? You like Russian brides, we like Russian brides, you know. You like bombing Syria, you know. It's fun, isn't it fun, you know? Putin controls your country, Putin, you know, there's...
And they love the Muslims now, but they'll never use Indian people. It just wouldn't, they just don't have the dangerous sound to them. It's always gotta be, it's gotta be the classic scene in the movie, you know? It's gotta be the United Nations gathered around a table. Then on the big screen comes that terrorist announcement. The assistant runs in, sir, sir, it's a message from the terrorist Boris. And they switch on the screen, pew, and then Boris comes on. Hello, United Nations. It is I, Boris. Boris Kublechnikov. I have placed bombs all over the world in major cities. And if you don't pay me $1 billion, I will make world go kaboom. You've got 1 hour. That's vidanya. And they'd be like, oh, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? They'd be scrambling for the money. They'd be, oh, what are we going to do? We'd never have an Indian guy doing that. Just wouldn't be the same. Assistant running into the room. Sir, sir, it's the infamous terrorist, Rajesh. They'd switch on the big screen. Pew, and there he'd be. Is it on? Okay. Hello. Hello, UN. Hello, namaste, namaste. Namaste, how are you, uncle, auntie? Pleasure, pleasure. My name is Rajesh, and I have placed bombs strategically all over the world. Now, if y'all don't pay me $1 billion, US, I will proceed to make the entire world go kaboom. They'd be like, but Rajesh, we don't have money, Rajesh, we don't have money, it's the credit crunch. Okay, how much you got then?
There's so much to talk about here going on in Russia right now and in Europe and the world and so on. And most of the time in the West, we have very little information about you. All we really have is some literature, some history and some movies. And the movies are not very reliable. And the best way I found to find out about Russian people is to say to a Russian person, what are they like? But I can only speak to the ones in the West. And the way they describe Russians is intense, because they say they're the best people in the world. I hate them. I love them, but I hate them. They're so ignorant and so stupid, and the most intelligent people I've ever met. They have amazing minds, they're incredibly stubborn, and they think about everything. They're very spiritual, but they're cold. They won't tell you anything. And then they tell you everything. They tell you everything that ever happened in their lives and what happened to their mother and their father and their grandmother and so on. And then they insist you stay for dinner. And you have to eat all the food, and the chairs, and the curtains. And you listen to this, and you think, wow, I didn't know it was so complex. And they say, it's not complex, it's the simplest thing in the world. What's wrong with you? Are you stupid or crazy or both? And you're fat. I love you. Here, eat this. And it's very intense. But that's the case when you're here and you're talking to people, because they have this... It's like people know a secret. It's in their eyes. When they listen to you, if you speak, there's kind of fireworks in the eyes. Because where I'm from, everybody's very expressive and demonstrative. You know, in Ireland, everybody goes, all the time, because it was never a powerful place. And so people made a big display when they speak. But here it's all in the eyes. People listen to you. And you feel like they really understand. They understand you in a way you've never been understood before. So you tell them more, and you tell them more. And they're looking, and these fireworks are in their eyes. And then... you wait for them to respond, and they come closer, and they say something like, do you like soup? Yeah, I like soup, yeah. Kind of. I know a place where we can get good soup. But is that all you're going to say to me? Is that your response to everything I've just told you about my life? No, we should go now, it will close. The other way to find out about Russians is from film. That's the obvious way. But the Hollywood presentation is very stereotypical. It is always the same. The men tend to be all, bad guys who say things like, since I come to your country, I make bomb. They have a scar that goes from here down to here, and their left hand is a blender or a hook or something. And it's very easy for me to make bomb because you Americans are so stupid. You spend all the time playing baseball and eating hamburger. And the women are very tragic. The women, they look far away all the time and they say, I don't want to talk about it. It doesn't matter. Not anymore. Well, only to me. It's too late for everything. Don't touch me. The look is, you know, is a very distinct Russian look, and then you come here and you see people have a very, the gender definition is very strong. Women look very feminine, and Orchin Stilnia and all that stuff, and the guys are, they have only two looks really. They either tend to be Muzhik or Chuvak, and that's it. Now the Chuvak is very easily recognizable type, you know, with the kind of floppy and complicated clothes thing. And the Muzhik is a, well, it's just a simpler kind of appearance. This and you know, the language is very beautiful, but it's very difficult. I like going into shops to use my 3-4 words of Russian so that I can pretend I can speak Russian for just a minute, and then the woman looks at me and says, "Что?" But I mean, I might as well just tell the truth, you know. I mean, at this stage there's no point pretending anymore. Я шпион. And ты тоже шпион. Я знаю. Работай на нас. Pastor Ray, I'm knowing. Я не вижу Толстого и Чакова. Я люблю Леди Гага. И донатс. Thank you very much.